Hello, let's get loud. All right, good morning, Cory here. It is a beautiful morning. I'm so glad you guys joined me. So this is strong. The only equipment you will need is maybe a mat. We're gonna do a couple of things with kneeling and then your weight. If you have a variety of weights, great. If you don't, no worries, we'll make do with what you have. Being really mindful and respectful of your body. Work to how you feel. Keep in mind, I'll progress and I'll regress, and you do what feels best for you. Let's take those feet nice and wide. We're gonna shift to your right and then to your left. Push the hands on the quadriceps and just start to push back into that hip. Push back into that butt. Both toes and knees are facing the camera. Nice and slow. And again, just feel the inner thighs warming up. Now in 10 seconds, we're gonna lift up that right leg and you're gonna hold it, and then we're gonna step back out into it. So this one, let's go. Lift it up and then step it back out. Push into it, maybe increasing a little bit farther or that short little step. Just as long as you're always keeping that knee and toe facing straight forward. So as you warm up, team, what's our goal for today? We already made it, right? We get to work out. Let's set a goal. Work the best that we can give today. Getting a little bit of everything. Maybe a lot more legs. So pace yourself. If it feels easy at any time, you know what to do. One more, and then we'll go back to shifting side to side. Let's go. Shift right and left. There we go. And again, in 10 seconds, we're gonna work on lifting that opposite leg. Next one, let's lift it. Lift it up, good. Now my music is a little bit faster. I'm gonna use something different. Just keep in mind the beat. I'm not able to slow down. It's not coming off of my phone. It's coming off that computer. Lift. And yes, that deceleration, perfect. 45 minute workout, about a 5 minute warm up. Kick it like Tabo. Two more. Perfect. Last one. Excellent. Back to side to side. There we go. Three, two, and the next one, pull that right leg in, and you're going to open up the shoulders and reverse, alternating leg. Good. Noticing how your quadriceps feel, how your shoulders feel. There we go. Bring that knee a little lower to the floor. Let the heel stay lifted, guys. So back heel is lifted, right? Bring that side heel. Now open the arms, hug, squeeze together. Yes, give it love this morning. Keeping your chest stacked over your hips. If you're tight, you're gonna feel that quadricep. 20 seconds. We are superstars. Good. Last one. Opposite side. Beautiful. All right. So grab your set of weights. These are lunges. And you're going to do these for a little bit of time, guys. So keep in mind, if you fatigue, if the heart rate gets too heavy, put the weights down and continue to go through the motion without the weight. Okay? So legs, it's going to increase your heart rate. Take your time. Big range of motion, nice and low to the floor. We're gonna alternate. So you're gonna give me a front right lunge, 12 o'clock. The same leg is gonna go 2 o'clock, okay? And then you're giving me a transverse to 4 o'clock, okay? We switch, left side, 12 o'clock, 10 o'clock, and then transverse, 8 o'clock, yes? Oh, no need to count. What I want you to do, though, was I held straight up. So if you want to work a little more quadriceps on this lunge, let me show you. Keep your shoulders stacked, okay? If you want to work a little more butt, and we're going to hit the butt, but feel free to do this. Hinge forward. See the difference? So I'm really pushing my chest towards my quadriceps, and then I come up, and then I do the same again, okay? So that just active changes that angle on that leg. So you choose which one you want to do. I'm probably going to do a variation of both. Here we go. Right leg forward. 12 o'clock. There you go. 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock. Alternate. Other side. 12 o'clock. 10 o'clock and 8 o'clock. Good. Now, these don't get my breath heavy. So I'm going to let you focus on how you feel. And I'm going to shut up, but I'm going to watch you. I like it. 1 minute down. So nice. Won't you hear the music pumping hard? Finish it up. You have less than 15 seconds. Finish it. Equal on both sides. This will be my last one on my left. Ooh, excellent. All right, guys, so you did that for 2 minutes. Nice work. You're gonna give me a windmill shoulder press. Legs resting, core tight, shoulder. So I want both of your feet turning to the left, okay? Weight is in the right hand. Now, bend into the left knee, put that hand, same side, and push to that hip. Boom, pop it with attitude. Now, elbows into my rib cage. Shoulders are away from the ear. You're gonna press it up, not overhead, lightly towards the direction of your hip. Slow on the down, elbow almost locked out at the top. Hold this, pull your abs in tight. 1 minute in 3, 2, all the way up. Elbow touches ribcage. Dumbbell touches shoulder. Beautiful, so you're still pushing your chest forward. You're leaning into that left leg. Your abs are in tight. Gorgeous. We call this a windmill shoulder. God. 35 seconds. It's right over the body. Nice. There you go. You turn around and gave that big booty a smack. 15 seconds, guys. I like it. So this is only 1 minute. And we'll switch to the other side. And then we are going into more hamstring split deadlift. So we're going to do legs and upper body and then back to a leg. We're alternating like that. Last one. Beautiful. All right. Flip it. Both toes turn to the right side. Right hand is on the quadricep. Okay. Give me attitude. All right, dig that elbow in. Here we go. Press it up. Down slow. Your shoulder is facing the same direction as that hand is reaching towards the ceiling, slightly to the hip. So Naj, push it away a little bit. Give me more hip action, Naj. Bring your feet a little closer together. And now hip. Any attitude in that left butt cheek, girl. There you go. Gorgeous. Like that. Low, low, low. Come on, you got less than 30 seconds. Remember, you're leaning on this, but you're still using both obliques to maintain that stability. So what this does is you guys have a little bit of a lighter weight. It adds, because of the angle, because of gravity, that extra work. Give me two more. Last one, down slow. Oh, so good. So the next one, if you have one heavy dumbbell, I'll take it. If you don't, two dumbbells will work. And I'm gonna give you or if you have a kettlebell, guys, that will work as well. In fact, I'm gonna grab my kettlebell. Ooh. I'm gonna regret this later. I'm gonna show you from a side. So it's a split deadlift, okay? This foot, my left, is not the one working, okay? So you can lift your heel or you can keep it anchored. But that knee is bent, okay? Opposite leg that is working, this will be my right, whatever one you're working. There's about a foot to a little bit less between my legs. My knee is bent, my hips go back, my chest drops, okay? And then I squeeze back up, not to here, okay? So the whole time, this is probably where I'm gonna start and this is where I'm coming back to. Both hands, grab the dumbbell. It goes down the leg you're working. Now, if you wanna go lower, you can, but as soon as you lose the back, the flat back, you have to stop, okay? And then you squeeze straight back up. You should feel it in that standing leg. Back flat, hip. All of the weight on the standing leg that you're working. Okay, here we go. In three, two, push your chest out, and squeeze up. Remember, are you coming full up? No. See, I'm still hinged a little bit. Why did I grab this big boy? I had good intentions. Woo! So, shoulders are drawn down. The whole time, your back is flat, your abs are engaged. Gorgeous. Split leg, deadlift. But I like it. So you can only go as low as your body will allow. If you're feeling your back, please stand up and take a little bit of a break. If you're not used to these, have to zip that belly button. Have to squeeze through the Kegels. Guys, you got less than 10 seconds. You're doing this for 1 minute. That front leg still bent. I wanted to lengthen it. Last one. All right. Same thing other side. How do we feel through that? Some good booty work right there. All right. Same thing other side. Either lift the heel. Light placement on that opposite leg. In three, two, let's go. There you go. So if you were doing like a jackknife where the leg is lifted, same thing, okay? But we're not. We have a little bit of weight placement in that opposite side. Gorgeous. Hip hinge, chest drop. Flat back. Beautiful. Morning, Shannon. Make sure you mute. Ooh. Hamstring, baby. 15 seconds. Good. Oh, yeah. Two more. Excellent, nice work. All right, guys, you're going into chest. You can do this kneeling. You can do this with both knees down. We can do this standing. So, let me be clear on this, okay? Palms are facing the camera. You're gonna soften your knees. Split stance, feet together. Now, I am scooping from my hip over to the opposite side, away from the body, crossing my midline. My thumb and my pinky always remain to the ceiling, okay? So the palm of the hand always scoops up to the ceiling, never turning. Soften the knees, you come up and across. Let me remind you, it's not here, it's not bicep. Push it out, try to go shoulder height, down slow, okay? If you feel that in your shoulder, bring it in a little bit. You should be feeling it right here in the armpit. All right, so we're doing this for 2 minutes. Here we go. In three, soften the knees. Two, right side, bring it up. Hold for that hot second, down slow. The release, eccentric, is where you're gonna feel it. Now, try to avoid turning your shoulders. Try to avoid turning your hips. Push it. Alternating, I call these scoops. Push it out. So Stephanie, leave that out there. I'll give you the side view. Push it out. There you go. Palm is facing up. Gorgeous. So we got the motion. I want you to try to focus on the breath. When do I breathe? Right now. Inhale and exhale as you lift. Gorgeous. Inhale and exhale slowly as you lift. Inhale. So the hardest part of the exertion, let that air out. Guys, you got 1 more minute. Back on that straight. Remember, you can split stance. This is a lot of core. The core is holding you to where your shoulders and your hips face straight forward. Your knees are bent. Oh, so the trick is to hold up there and go 1,001. And then down slow. 1,001. Nice. We have about 30 seconds. You guys look so good. Happy Thursday. So we're going back to another deadlift, but this time with both legs. So if you feel your hamstrings are shot for whatever reason, you can even do this with no weight, okay? So make sure you progress or regress. Do you love those hamstrings, but also challenge them? Last one. Excellent. All right. One dumbbell, two dumbbells. Now I'm gonna show you from a side just because this is important. Again, you are never gonna come up. So you always wanna make sure your feet are even. Okay, take your stance a little bit wider. Now, a deadlift starts with the knees bent, the hip hinge, the butt goes back. Okay, but what I'm gonna have you do is go here. So you're gonna grab and you're gonna come up and then down and up and down. And once again, your butt is never gonna squeeze all the way up. Now, if it gets too fatiguing, you grab it, come up, and then let it down and then come all the way up. That is okay to regress to, okay? You can do one in between with no weight, it's up to you. But you have a mirror. To look in the camera at yourself. Make sure, guys, that you're not doing this. This is all lower back weight and I'll have a disc issue, okay? So the butt goes back, your weight is in your heels, your toes are light, and then you squeeze up and then back down. We're doing this for 1 minute. Are you ready? In five, abs are tight. Four, three, two, let's go. Ooh. Now the floor is just there as a reminder to how low I maybe can try to get. Does not have to be fast. The regression is here. You give that back a break, okay? I'm giving the regression, I'm going back to the progression. Just try not to stop. 15 seconds. Push back. Push back. Kneeling low. On the other side. 3, 2, back flat. Last one. Excellent. Nice work, guys. Get some water. All right. Kneeling row. So, I want you to put, let's go this way. You guys will face me. One leg in front, doesn't matter which one. Knee on the mat. So on this row, you're anchored, whatever leg is in front, that elbow to that knee, quadricep. You're gonna reach the weight forward, pull it behind you, hold, and release slow. Chest, shoulders face the floor, flat back. Abs are engaged. Now, not straight down, reach forward, pull. Only the length of your arm, not this, okay? Shoulder does not move. Slow. 1 minute, 3, 2, let's go. Gaze is down at the floor. What part of your back are you feeling? Palm is facing inside of the leg that's in front. Reach it forward, pull it back. Now some of you will automatically lift the chest trying to get higher behind you. No. Now just push your chest out to flatten that back and come up out of that shoulder. There you go. So I'll show you this. You were kind of like this. All hunch. Open it up. Reach it past that foot. Gorgeous. I wish I could see some of you guys hiding this morning. Less than 10 seconds. Everybody's back is really strong. I love to see those heavier weights. Last one. Gorgeous. All right. Which side? How we doing, kids? You're crushing it today. Remember, that attitude is, I'll try. I get to work out. Instead of I have to work out, use that mapping. It does work. Here we go. In 5, opposite side. 4, 3, 2, let's go. Flat back. How do I flatten my back? I push my chest to the floor. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. Stephanie, no moving your shoulder. My shoulder is not moving. It's stuck in cement. The only thing moving is my arm and the elbow driving up to the ceiling. Holding for that quick, hot second. Good. Think of spreading your shoulders apart. So squeeze your scapula blades together. So the two chicken bones behind your back, open up that chest. There you go. 15 seconds. Had a couple hits and a couple solos. Now I got a couple bricks and a couple mobiles. Nice. Everybody local. I was just last one. Down with the man there at the polo. Excellent. Very good. All right. Getting some sweat on in here. Okay, guys, I want you to grab your weight for hammer curls and bicep curls. You're doing this for 4 minutes. So remember, hammer curl is here. Thumb goes to shoulder. Elbow does not move. If your elbow is here, I'll take it. If your elbow is here, I'll take it. But never does the elbow move through the motion. Avoid that, okay? Now, we gotta get those inner thighs. So what I want you to do is focus on the legs first. So, feet start off together. You're gonna alternate side to side. You give me a short little step. Shift into the hip just like we did in warm-up. Drop the chest, long, flat back. Come back up center, hammer curl. Step to the other side, back up center, hammer curl. Now, 2 minutes. The first minute, hammer curl. The second minute will be a regular bicep curl, but you're still alternating. Are we ready? 3, 2, side step. Hammer curl. Side step. Now, a lot of people tend to drop their chest versus pushing their hips back. So when you step, that left toe should be able to lift. Most of the weight is in the heel. On my right side, the side is stepping. Now the left. Lift the toe. Toe and knee are still straight forward. Show you from the side, guys. See my chest is lifted. Woo! I'm keeping the hip, the knee, and the ankle all alignment. If you want to step a little wider, can you? Absolutely. Just keep the toe and knee straight forward. On the next one, bicep curl. Switch it. These are now bicep curls. From here, oh, hello. Woo. Can you swing a little bit with momentum like I'm doing? Yes. Why not? Especially if you're fatiguing. At the beginning, do I want you? No. Do I still want your elbows down to the floor? Yes. Less than 30. Woo. You got it. Can you just stop with the bicep curl? Yes, you can. Last one. Keep doing the legs. Last one to the opposite side. Woohoo! All right. One or two dumbbells. You're gonna do a split stance, tricep overhead, okay, extension. You can do these kneeling. What I want you to do is if you're here, make sure you're not feeling it in your back and start to feel the lower back. So split stance is always welcome. Now, T, try to get as low as you can, not here, and then extend all the way down, all the way locking at the top. Grab the dumbbells or one. Back up a little bit here. Woo-hoo. All right, are we ready? 1 minute. Drop it down. Lean into it. Lock at the top. Lock at the top. Just like scratching deep in the middle of the rhomboid. You're reaching down as far as you can. Your abs are tight. Low. Lock at the top. Now you know you grabbed the right weight if what? You're already getting burning. I'm already getting burning. Ooh, tell me a story. I don't have to think about it. Yeah, unlock. Now if your range starts to shorten, that's okay right now. You got less than 15 seconds. Wow. Woo. Hello. And last one. Goodness. All right, guys, how we feeling? We good? Perfect. All right, let's go. Down to the floor. You're gonna give me a test, okay? You're gonna fly on the down, turn the palm, press up. So it's a fly with a chest press. Ooh. So I'm gonna turn this way so you guys can see. Your choice is either put the feet flat, lift the butt, leg tabletop. Always options. So where I want you to start, push your chest out. If your feet are flat, your lower back is off the floor. Take the palms towards each other. Soften the elbows. Let the elbows come down at a slight angle towards your hips. Touch the elbows to the floor. Turn the palms towards the knees. Press it up. Touch the weights together. Palms face each other. We're going this for 2 minutes. Are we ready? In 3, 2, lie down slow. Turn the palms towards the knees. Press up quick. Yes. Down. Press it up. Gorgeous. Lie on and down. Turn. Press it up. Now as a reminder, if you're on a bench, you never want your elbows go lower than your shoulders. If you're on the floor, you don't have to worry about that because it automatically stops at the floor. But I want you to notice your palm, your wrist, is slightly around that elbow, guys. A lot of times people extend that forearm because they feel the stretch and they feel it. Yeah, you're going to feel that in your shoulders later. Avoid that. Low on the down. Press it up. So the palms face each other. That's a fly as you go down. Turn. Press up. Fly on the down. Low and a chest press on the way up. Let me see you guys. So good. Fly on the down. Yes. Awesome, guys. You have less than 30 seconds. Love it. Remember, you're hugging a tree on the way down. Your arms never extend through a hug, right? Keep that bend. Perfect form. Last 10 seconds. Woo-hoo. 3, 2. Excellent. All right. Gotta pop up for another leg. Yes? Couple options. 1 dumbbell, 2 dumbbells. Now you guys know, if you do a squat with dumbbells up here, it's a little harder. So I'd love for you guys to start off there. Or you can hold goblet squat. But what is key? So if I'm squatting with these 2 dumbbells, but I can only go right here to start off with, what should I do? Set those freaking weights down and go lower, okay? I want you to at least go parallel to the knee or slightly under. Not here, this is nothing. But your glute does not work until you get that butt down. It's not gonna start to work until you get the range of motion and then you add the weight. So, regress, no weights, weights here, weights up here, up to you. 2 minutes, woo! Okay, say that. Here we go. 3, 2, let's go. Now I want you to notice your feet are even. Your heels stay anchored. Some of the weight's in the heels, some of the weight's in the ball of the foot. Spread your toes. Your chest is just slightly in front of the hips. So good. Woo! Come on, Shannon. Nice, 70. A little lower. That's it, Naj. So, you'll get stronger legs, but if you start to shorten that range of motion, you really want to work the butt. Drop the weight. Keep moving through it. Squeeze. Tension the knees towards each other. Using the inner thighs. Everything works through a squat, guys. Upper body, core, every part of the leg. 45 seconds. Whew. Oh yeah. Nice. We have a shoulder work on the other side. No repeat. Thursday. I can't breathe. It is hot. Oh. So for me, I'd better get that range of motion every time. One more team. Excellent. Whew. Can we get some water? We're going into the W. How are we feeling? All right. So the W is what? Middle, a little bit of anterior, medial, posterior shoulder. Okay? So your job, I'll show you from the side, is to reach with your thumb, not your elbow. The elbow does not lead the raise. Okay? Your elbow points down, allowing external rotation on the shoulder. Your thumb reaches farther behind you, not the elbow. Okay, so say thumb, lead. Now, palms face each other. Inhale, exhale. Open the body to reach the thumbs back behind you. You're making a W. See my hands here? Inhale, exhale, squeeze. So these blades right here, see them? Squeeze together. Squeeze together. Squeeze together. External rotation on the shoulder. Working that medial and posterior a little bit stronger. I'll face you, slow and controlled. Ready? Here we go. Inhale, left down. Thumb leads the direction. So, are you using a little bit of upper body momentum? Yeah? Only because you are keeping the abs tight and it helps externally rotate. Hinge and open. Beautiful. Here we go. Back side. Oh yeah. Squeeze together. Elbows slightly point down to the floor too. Forward. Got it. I feel like a revolving chicken. Woo! Nice, guys. Less than 10 seconds. So notice I'm holding it for that hot second. External rotation protects the shoulder. One more. Beautiful. All right. Woo! You have one more thing to do. So I want one dumbbell. So if it's heavy, if it's not, load up on more than one in one hand. Now, if you need to hold on to something, you can. I have this. You can do that, okay? So what we're gonna do, standing leg, so I'll start off where you guys have the right leg, is the one, woo, is gonna be doing the work. So it's opposite side. So what I want you to do, if your right leg is working, you're gonna hinge forward, back leg comes behind you, palm is facing the camera, row, and then come straight back up. If you don't have good balance, hold on to something, okay? Back leg goes back, I hold, under grip row, I come straight back up. Hamstring, butt, core. Show you from the side. Try to avoid going so low, okay? Now, if you need to, you can tap that foot down, and this is modified. Yes, this is progression. Soften a standing leg. Yes, flat to the floor. Row, straight back up. Choose your poison. I'm gonna hold on. Is this left side, which will be your right, is not as strong. 1 minute, here we go. Hinge. It takes a lot of oblique, a lot of core work to maintain that balance. We all need to work it. Never stop working it. Good. If you fatigue, put a little weight on that back leg. So I just showed modified. Under grip row. How high can you get your elbows to the ceiling? Guys, you're still reaching that elbow up nice and high. There you go. Hip flat. reach from out of that hip socket of that leg going long. Come on, Naj. Feel higher, higher with the elbow. Woo! There we go. Let me see it. Nice. That's it. That's Shannon. Good deal. Cool. Three. Two. Nice. All right, guys, switch sides. We're going in 10 seconds. This is it. Cool down after this. You hit your chest twice. You hit your shoulders twice. You hit your back twice. You hit those legs pretty good. Let's go. Stay back up. Modified. Toe tap. Flat back. Shoulders square to the floor. Standing leg. Knee is slightly bent. Ooh. Now this under grip row works a different area of the back. Oh, there's a big breeze in here. 30 seconds, a little bit less. Flat back. Yes. Last one. Awesome. Great job, guys. All right. Let's stretch you guys out. You did it. Please take a little more time to stretch longer than what I'm giving you. Let's go into that kneeling lunge. One knee down, push your hips forward, squeeze your butt cheek, open the chest. Good. Now take the arms behind you. Just open the chest, release them down. Clasp the hands behind. So keeping the chest lifted and just lift up through the hands. Your abs are engaged, shoulders are drawn down. Nice work today. Remember, if you want more free workouts, follow me on Instagram, Backyard Fitness by Cory. If you're not following me on YouTube, check it out, Backyard Fitness by Cory. Smash that like button, subscribe, comment below, and release. Now, grab that foot behind, pull it up. If your hips turn, release the foot. If the hips stay facing the same direction, hold in a little bit. Quadriceps. Hold it down. Just breathe. Like to know if you guys like the workout. Comment on my YouTube. If you like the full body, never repeating. Some of you guys like repeating, which is great because now you can go back and repeat, right? Heart rate was elevated. So yes, you burn fat, build muscle, release that. Excellent. Now just sit back, leg extends in front of you. Pick your hands straight up and just hinge a little bit. You don't have to reach down to your toes, holding that anterior tilt through your pelvis. If this hurts your knee, just turn the sole of the foot to the inside of the thigh. From what I saw, you guys look great today. So glad you joined me. Excellent, come all the way up. We'll switch opposite leg forward. And again, push into that hip. Oh yeah. Let's take one arm, reach down the center of the back and stretch the tricep. Keeping your abs still engaged. Grab the other hand, reaching that elbow. Just give it a little bit of pressure. Switch other hand. Oh, but release the hand, grab that foot. One side might be a little more flexible, one side might be tighter. Pay attention to that. Notice your hips didn't turn. That leg up. Good. You want to hold your stretches for 45 seconds. I've held just a little bit less than that. Remember, if you're a little bit sore tomorrow, do something. Walk around the lake, spinning with me at 9 a.m. Anything, just get some blood flow. It will help with that soreness. Delayed onset muscle soreness is usually 2 days. That's dome. And release that leg, lean back. Otherwise, turn the sole of the foot to the inner thigh, reach your hands, and then just hinge just a little bit. Your arms are heavy like mine, you can just bring them down. But I want you to avoid just rounding, because that's lower back, and right now we're focusing on the hamstring. Give me all, give me all. Excellent. Coming all the way up, guys. Oh, big inhale. Reach it up center. Bring the hands down to the heart center. You guys were awesome today. Thank you so much, guys. I hope you have